Hello, and welcome back to Rare Trains on the MBTA Worcester Line. Today's episode begins in the summer of 2022, where I'm at Wellesley Square Station waiting for MBTA train number 2512 and inbound to Boston. Today's 2512 is running a few minutes behind schedule as it's towing a dead train into Boston. After a previous outbound train broke down in the Worcester area, 2512 was tasked with hooking up to the train, a practice known as making a double draft. These two trains tied together have a total of 9 cars and 2 HSP-46 locomotives. Watch as 2512 rolls out of the square with the trailing engine completely shut off. Not something you see every day. About a week later, after chasing CSX Local L005 between Framingham and Medfield, a couple of friends and I got word that CSX Y201, a yard move, would be Y-ing or turning around some locomotives from Worcester. Right before midnight, we arrived in Framingham to see a line of 5 CSX mainline GEs coming off the East Y. Gibos aren't something you see too often on the Worcester line these days, thanks to the implementation of AXIS and PTC signaling systems. The leading engine on this train lacks such a system, so it was most likely running under some sort of exemption. A few minutes later, after coming off the Y in Framingham, the power move hustles back to Worcester. These locomotives will most likely be used on late night and early morning intermodals to points west. The next day, I just so happened to go out to see Amtrak's Lakeshore Limited through Wellesley, but to my surprise, 50th Anniversary Unit Number 100, the Midnight Blue, was leading. 100 pays homage to Amtrak employees who work late into the night to keep the trains moving. A few weeks later, I'm in Wellesley again to see the same train with the same engine leading. This time though, Amtrak's inspection car, the American View, is bringing up the rear with now former Massachusetts Governor Charlie Baker. Baker rode this train all the way to Pittsfield with Amtrak officials to inspect the line slated for future east-west rail service in the state. Later that day, a few stops east at Wellesley Farms, I'm seeing the eastbound Lakeshore Limited. Leading is P42 number 108, which showcases Amtrak's future Phase 6 paint scheme. The next day, I'm even further east at CP11 in Weston. Here's the westbound lakeshore once again with 108, passing the vintage searchlight signals. That night, I returned to the square once again to see the lakeshore. This time around, it's got the regular Amtrak P-42s up front and a special guest hitching a ride third. This is C.P-40DC number 6710, returning from Amtrak's Beech Grove shops in Indiana, where it received a light overhaul and a fresh coat of paint. On August 30th, CSX Y101, the Framingham switcher, was supposed to go into Boston to pick up an empty welded rail car, but after a series of unfortunate events, it came back empty-handed. As has been the case for the past few years, it's pretty uncommon to see CSX east of Framingham. Over a month later, in mid-October, I got word that the MBTA's Power Wash train was running on the Worcester Line. Minutes after I got done with school for the day, the wash train came through with one of the MBTA's few remaining non-rebuilt F-40s leading. This train runs through October and November, washing leaves off the tracks. A few days later, I heard once again that an MBTA extra was running during the school day, and thanks to a canceled class, I was able to see it. This is the MBTA Reedville switcher rolling through Wellesley with a Longhood Forward GP40MC and a single MBB coach. This car was recently rebuilt in New Jersey, and the switcher was tasked with hauling it into Boston. Not only is a GP40MC a rare sight on the south side, but leading Longhood Forward on the main line is even more unique. Finally, in early November, I was out for yet another extra with the GP40, this time a rail train. After the recent one-month shutdown of the Orange Line, extra sections of rail were sold off to the Grafton and Upton Railroad, a local short line. This extra consisted of MassDOT GP40 number 1137 pulling four flat cars with scrap rail. These sections of rail will eventually be used on the Grafton and Upton, where track speed limits are lower.